Hello students, good morning. We have already started a topic distance formula. We have also discussed what are the objective of this topic. We have also discussed some objective related to this topic. Now let us discuss which topics objective we have also discussed. We have discussed how to find distance when two points are given. When two points are given, how to find distance by applying the distance formula. We have also discussed how to find distance from one point to origin. In this case, origin point is also given and one another point is given and you have to find out the distance by using the distance formula. Now, according to its objectives, its next topic is equidistance. One point is there. Whether that point is at equidistance from other two points. Now, before starting our topic, let us recall our previous lecture. What we have done in our previous lectures. In our previous lectures, we have also discussed that when two points are there, how to apply the distance formula. Let us suppose point A is 1, 2, point B is 3, 4. And I have to find out the distance between point A and B. Which formula we will apply? We will apply the same formula, distance formula. First point is represented as x1, y1. Second point is representation for the x2 and y2. By applying distance formula, we can find out the distance between A and B. Same way, in our second lecture, we have done about origin. One point is for origin and one another point is given to you. How to find out the distance from origin to the related point? Origin point we represented as x1, y1. Given point we represented with x2, y2. Then same we apply the distance formula to find the distance between origin to given point. So what is the distance formula there? Distance formula is d is equal to x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square under root. Now according to our today topic is equidistance, which word meaning are the combination of two word, equidistance. Equi means equal, distance means distance. Now what is the meaning of full word? Full word meaning is having the equal distance. Having the same distance. To understand this concept, let's take one example there. If I am saying that Bias is at a 35 km from Amritsar and Jalandhar, then it means on distance between Bias to Amritsar, Bias to Jalandhar is same. If I am saying that Ram is sitting at a distance of 10 meter from Mohan, 10 meter from Sohan. What does it mean? It means Ram is sitting at same distance from Mohan and Sohan. Now, if I am asking to you people that ki P is at same distance from point B or A, then you ask me, ma'am, what is the distance between PB and PA? It means we should know the distance between these two points. We should know the distance between these two points. If we knowing the distance between these points, then also we can say that P is at same distance from B as well as A. It means first of all, we will find out the distance between these two points. And again, then we will find out the distance between these two points. Then how to find out the distance between two given points? By applying same formula, distance formula. Now, first of all, we will find out the distance between PB. Then we will find out the distance between PA. It means whenever equidistance word is there, we will apply distance formula two times because we must know the distance between the two values. To find out the distance between these two values, we apply distance formula two times. Now, we will discuss type of questions there. Now, what type of question will be there? First type of question is, show that P 5 2 is equidistant from point A and B. Now point P, we have to solve that कि P is at the same distance from point A and from point B. According to distance word, we will apply which formula there? We will apply the distance formula. According to equidistance word, how many time we will apply the distance formula? We will apply 2 time distance formula. Let's start with the solution there. Now, solutions, we will write down the point P 5, 2, A 2, 3, B 8, 1. What distance is there? Then we will write down the distance formula. D is x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square under root. Equidistance means we have to find out PA is equal to PB. We write down that PA is equal to PB. Now we have to prove that, we have to show that the point is at same distance or not. Therefore, we will put box there. We do the partition there. For one side, we will find out the value of PA. We will write down the points of P, points of A. First point is for x1, y1. Second point is for x2, y2. For the same case, PB. First point is for x1, y1. Second point is for x2, y2. Now we will find out the value of PA. PA. PA, x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square. Plus minus, sine of minus, add the number. Minus 3 whole square, plus minus, sine of bigger term, subtract the number. Now minus 3 whole square is 9, 1 square is 1, 9 plus 1 is 10, under root 10 units. Same way we will find out the value of PB. 8 minus 5 whole square, 3 whole square. 1 minus 2 whole square, minus 1 whole square. 3 square is 9, minus 1 square is 1. So 9 plus 1 is 10 units. Now both are having the same answer. Under root 10 units, under root 10 units. Therefore, we will put equal sign in between the box there. PA is equal to PB. Now, because question is in the form of that, show that P is equidistant from A and B, then our answer will be also in the same way. Therefore, P is equidistant from A and B. Now, let's take one more example there. Another example is P 1, 3 equidistant from A 3, 1 and B 3, 5. Now we will start with the solution there. We will write down the point P A B. According to distance word is there, we will write down the distance formula. Distance formula is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Now we have to prove that point P is at same distance from A and B. Therefore, we will find out PA and PB. How many times we will apply the distance formula? According to the word equi, we will apply distance formula 2 times. Now, PA, we will put in box there, PB there. With one side, we will write down the value of PA, PA. First value is for x1, y1. Second is for x2, y2. Find out the value of PA by substituting the values. 3 minus 1 whole square, 1 minus 3 whole square. Again, algebra rule is there. Plus minus, sine of bigger term, subtract the number. 2 whole square, 1 minus 3, sine of bigger term, subtract the number. Minus 2 whole square. Minus square number is always positive. 2 square plus 2 square. 4 plus 4, under root 8. Now we can do the prime factorization there. 2 into 2 into 2, answer is 2 under root 2. Same way we can find out the value of PB. PB value is under root 53 units there. Now PB is under root 53 units. These two values are not same. Now what sign we will put here? Not equal sign. We will put PA not equal to PB. And what is the answer there? Therefore, P is not at equidistance from A and B. P is not at equidistance from A and B. Now, Ajay, let's discuss what objectives we have already done from the given topic, what we have learned from the given topic, we learn that where to apply the distance formula, when to apply the distance formula, how to apply the distance formula. Next, when two points are there, how to find out the distance between these two points by applying the distance formula. Now, third is how to find out the distance when a point and origin is given to you. Now, our today concept is about the equidistance. In equidistance, how we find out the distance between two points are same. We will apply the distance formula for two times for the equidistance, and if the distance between these two points are same, then we will write down point is at the same distance. If no, then we will write down points are not at the same distance. Now students, you will receive one worksheet and one link related to this topic. Please go through that link also and try to solve that worksheet. I hope you will do it. Thank you.